I was recently in a coaching session with one of my clients. He kept battering himself over how many unfinished tasks he had on his plate. He said 10 years ago, he could read a book from start to finish in a few days. But now, even when he really wants to read a book, he gives up after reading a few chapters. I could hear a lot of frustration in his voice for not being able to do things. I also noticed he was trying to be a 100% achiever in every area of his life. And if he wasn't at 100%, he felt he wasn't good enough. That affected his ability to get things done, finish tasks on his plate, and lead a restful and a happy life. As we went through our session, I helped him identify the many buckets of his life that he had to focus on. Self, close relationships, social relationships, work, entertainment, cultural escapades, learning, reading. I asked him to write down the expectations and activities in each area. Next, I asked him to estimate the time each of those activities would require. Once he started writing that down, he saw limited time each day, which was not enough for the number of activities he wished to accomplish each day. He realized what he expected of himself was brutal and could never be achieved as time was limited and the expectations he had of himself were very high. A lot of us fall into this trap of wanting to be at 100% in every area of our life. And when we are not, we feel we are useless, lazy, good-for-nothing beings, and we end up feeling terrible about ourselves all the time. While everything is important, we need to prioritize what is really important for the next quarter, the next year, the next 5 years. All of us need to do this exercise that I did with my client to define our buckets and our priorities. So if you wish to be at 100% in your work and close relationships bucket right now, and 40% in the gym, and 5% in your reading habits, you will be absolutely fine if you do not master every exercise at the gym, if you're not the best topmost weightlifter at the gym, and if you're not reading a book in 2 months. Your doing or not doing those tasks does not define you. Your priorities and your focus in pursuing them is what defines you. When you're fine with being at 80% in some buckets and 10% in the other, you find you're more peaceful, relaxed, and focused. You develop self-compassion and acceptance of what you can do. When life throws its curveballs, you can reassess your priorities and adjust accordingly. You are a human being with body, mind, and emotions. Recognize that as you identify the different buckets of your life, mark your priorities, and perform them with excellence. Wish you all the best.